When I was 15 years old, I was going for a walk along a beach in Southwest Rocks, and I decided that was the spot I was going to propose to my wife-to-be. In August this year, Angela and I went up there. My mother and father came down with us because they had to plant a note under a rock.
We went for a walk down South End. By the time we came back, he pointed out a note.
I said, there's a note written over there. She said, nah, it's just rubbish. I said, no, I'm pretty sure it's a note. There's something written on it.
Had me read it, asked me to turn around.
As she was turning around, I got down on one knee, got the engagement ring out. There was my grandmother's engagement ring. And she turned around with tears in her eyes, and I said, would you marry me? She said, I'll think about it.
It was very beautiful, yeah, very sweet, just stunning.
He had it all planned out since he was 15, and I was a lucky girl that he proposed to.
I love my family more than anything else. My brothers and sister, they're just mates of mine. I don't see them as relations that I have to do things with. They're just mates that I ring up and go for a beer with.
I'm looking forward to sharing this, not just with Barnaby, but my whole family. Mostly, of course, my mum, who is so special to me because she loves so incredibly unconditionally.
One of our first deep conversations, she said that the thing she loves the most is her family. That's what Angela and I love about each other, and that's why we're getting married today.
The concept that was taught to us since we were little kids at church was something that I held on to because I thought it was quite special. The idea that we're walking in as two separate people with two separate spirits, and we leave with one spirit. So that's what marriage is to me. It's the union of our spirits. For the rest of our lives, we'll have one spirit. It's just very romantic.
When we see just the interactions between our families and Andrew and I speaking to our families, that's what I'm looking forward to the most. It's really not that far. I want just people talking to people, catching up and talking about, you know, things that aren't really that important in the whole grand scheme of things. Just enjoyment. I want family to love family at our wedding.
Just looking forward to just celebrating the start of the rest of our lives together, which I know is very cliche, but that's what it is. One day I will get there. One day. Everybody there that loves us to bits will be there celebrating with us, and it's just going to be the best day. Yeah, it's just going to be wonderful.
After Angela and I got engaged, we sat down and started talking about where we wanted to go for our honeymoon. We both decided we wanted to travel the world together. So that starts right now. We're heading off to Auckland, New Zealand.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart.
Our world tour honeymoon kicked off on the central coast of New South Wales, where we stayed in a beach house thanks to the Miles family. Now Barnes and I are in Auckland, New Zealand, where we are staying with Fiona, Mark, Jimmy and Garth. We're here because Barnes has been invited to be a guest on Sky TV's Wake Up Your Wow with Cath Vincent. After 4 days in Auckland, we reach our departure day. We're not sure where the next leg of our trip will take us. All we know is that when we get there, we'll still be madly in love.
Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.